Give Jen Shure a message. I'll send it to her.
How much dancing do you do?
You walk.
I dance all the time. I close places. I close them.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, oh, oh. Chicks would be like, whoa, this right there. Wow. But you said,
So coach, you're telling Jen Shure she has to dance more.
Dance more! You have to dance more!
Hajime!
Today marks the official 2-year anniversary of me making these vlogs.
It's a night owl, get it?
So 2 years ago I made this vlog, and last year I made this vlog, and this year I'm making
this vlog.
She good to go. I can dance.
I always do the big milestone numbers at points like this, and so as of today, we have 1,074 subscribers on YouTube.
That's a lot of subscribers.
95,300 total views.
That's also a lot of views.
And I would never have guessed I'd still be making these vlogs.
2 years later.
I'm kind of reflecting, and I've met a lot of really cool people over the last year. Been to a lot of really cool places, been to a lot of really cool meets. I've learned a lot and improved in a bunch of ways, so overall it was a pretty good year. And, season 3 will be even better.
Cause I'm smarter. I think. I hope.
So let's get back to the good stuff. I didn't really film a lot last week cause of my rest and test week. So I rested.
And, I tested.
All my test numbers were down.
Ah! I'm getting worse and I'm training harder. What's up with that? No!
After I got done, I kind of reassessed why the numbers were down.
One.
I did eccentric lifts for an extra week this week, and the weights were a little heavier.
Two.
I upped the tempo runs and the volumes a little bit, and just about everything.
More stuff. Three.
Last year, I had about 10 weeks off before I started training again. This year, I had just under 6.
And I wasn't really mentally resting because there was other shenanigans going on.
I was bummed out at first. I re-looked at why the numbers could have been that way, and I feel alright about it. And the only thing that really improved was my vertical, which is cool, because I haven't really been training for it. I'm hoping this all pays off down the road, because the first month of training is never fun. So since I didn't have a lot of footage, I asked you guys to ask me questions, and I said I'd pick 10, but since I'm making this late, I'll do a few extras.
But it's gonna be great, so here we go. One. Hey Sean, what's your favorite meet you've ever competed at?
Honestly, I'd have to go with Brit's Pub because we were on a roof. And it was with my friends and that meet was just awesome. And two, Drake Relays. I just love the Drake Relays since I've been going there forever and I worked my way up.
Drake Relays, normal competition college to the elite to now in the mall. And how do you beat jumping the mall? That was pretty awesome.
And I got to jump with the world record holder. Also awesome!
Hey Sean, how did you and Carrie meet?
We met on the interweb.
Cause I don't like to go out to bars, and she was meeting a lot of weirdos at bars.
So she met a weirdo online instead.
Three. Hey Sean, what do you think you'll do when your pole vault career ends?
I don't know.
If you have any ideas, let me know, please. Four. Hey Sean, when are you coming to see KMR, aka Team Hoot South?
Hopefully very soon.
I have to have a talk with Captain Coach Riggs. Hey Sean, what is your dream height slash goal height you always wanted to hit before hanging it up?
Because when I was a 16-foot vaulter, I just dreamed of jumping 17 feet. And then when I got to 17 feet, I was like,
oh man, it'd be pretty cool if I jumped 18 feet.
And then when I jumped 18 feet a bunch of times, I kind of realized that I don't really have a dream height anymore.
I mean, there's some numbers floating around that would be cool.
I've learned to live for the journey more than the destination. Because once you reach the destination, the thing is, the numbers are kind of like rungs of a ladder, and once you reach a rung and you get there,
huh, I wonder what that next ring is like, so you look up and you grab it.
So I'm going to keep continuing on the journey until I end up going backwards.
Six. Hey John, if you could have one superpower, what would it be?
I'd want a superpower where I can change my superpowers.
Kind of like a super chameleon.
Or I want to make people fart just by pointing at them. I think that'd be funny. A super chameleon.
Seven! Hey, Sean, what has been your biggest epiphany in regards to training pole vault in the last couple of seasons?
I've had a few really big epiphanies. Rest is the single most important thing a high-level athlete can do.
And I suck at it. I'm really bad. Every year I'm like, I'm not gonna overtrain, and then I do.
Two!
There's more than one way to skin a cat.
Do not get lumped into one specific set way of training. There are lots of ways for you to adapt your body.
And number 2.5.
If you can make training in pole vault fun, you can't fail.
Find ways to make it fun. Hey, Sean! When did you realize, hey, I can go pro at this? I have what it takes. If you had to narrow it down to one moment.
I still don't consider myself pro.
I'm living with my parents. Professionals don't live with their parents.
One of the big pushes to keep this going was in 2010 when I got 5th place at the USATF Championships.
Huh, maybe I should keep doing this for just a little while longer to see what else I can do. Nah! Hey Sean, what is going to happen with Team Hoot?
I don't know. I have ideas for Team Hoot that could be pretty cool. I just have to find some time. I think Team Hoot could be pretty cool and help out more people than just in the pole vault world.
Amoeba! It could be everything and everywhere.
10! Seven!
Hey Sean, are you going to make a video? I forgot my glasses!
Yeah!
Hey Sean, are you going to make a video on lifting or lifting technique and form? And what is the worst thing that ever happened to you during a pole vault?
That's a really good idea! What lifts are you curious about technique-wise? Let me know in the comments below. The worst thing that ever happened to me is I was trying out 15-foot poles for the first time in high school, and I came up short and landed in the box and sprained my ankle.
2 weeks before state, and ended up getting second at state on misses.
Boo.
11.
Let's go technical, bro. Let's discuss the P step, aka penultimate step, and see if we can make some of these high school kids think about it just a little bit.
The penultimate step is important. I always coach it like a basketball layup.
If you want to get more energy going forward, are you going to have more energy running or jumping?
Most would say jumping. So by having a penultimate step, it puts you in a better takeoff position and moves the energy at the appropriate angle for takeoff efficiency. Think about doing a layup into your takeoff, just like Michael Jordan did when he was jumping from the free throw line.
12. Whoops. 12.
Hey Sean, what are all your training phases you do in a year? How do you train for those phases and how long do you do them for?
Okay, I work my way backwards. I look at when I want to peak and I work my way backwards from there. If I want to peak for indoor champs, if I'm just doing my indoor cycle, I usually have indoor champs and then before that I put a comp cycle that lasts a month. And before that cycle I put a pre-comp cycle that lasts about a month. And then I have 2 months before that one, which is specific prep, and then 2 months before that, which is general prep. So that's about 6 months of training, and that's just indoor. And each cycle is about 3 weeks with the rest week. So thanks for watching for 2 whole years.
And let's hope you continue to watch for 3. I'll try to continue to be entertaining.
And give you information that is worth your time. Please subscribe and follow me on Instagram and Twitter at
Sean Danger Hoot.
All these links are in the description below. One last thing before I leave. Everyone should follow youtube.com/fitchicksarah. Sarah Shepherd is an elite pole vaulter training with Joe Dial, who is brilliant in the form of nutrition. If you guys ever have nutrition questions that you keep asking me, I'm going to start sending them her way. Or go to her Facebook page, fitchicksarah.
It's awesome. She's got a lot of good stuff up there. And she's way better at nutrition stuff than I am. So go check it out.
Thanks for everyone who asked questions, and I will see you next week. It is, because that's my standard, and my grip from 3 last year wasn't very high, but now doing it from 2, that's progress. I'm pumped. Secondly, you guys are probably thinking,
that's not 2 lefts. You have a skip in there. A yippity-dippity-skippity-yippity.
All my approaches have a little